Hello guys, welcome back with me, Chao 2025 in Stable Diffusion, how to create LoRA using Google Colabs. Don't even need a GPU at all to create a LoRA here. So this is the example that a LoRA I created, Ryuji Sakamoto. I just created this LoRA just a few minutes ago. And it's not taking a lot of time actually to create this kind of LoRA. First, you need to access Google Colabs I put in a link in the description. This is Kohya LoRA Dreambooth. Just enter the Colabs, ignore the warning. Okay, what you need to do is first, you need to install dependency and make sure you put install explorer and move drives. Make sure you do this or else your model gonna be creeped somewhere else, you know? And you don't want that, so have to do this, just play this, it's gonna process like this. Then after that, you don't need to do this, you need to download the available model or the pretend model. In this case, because I want to train on any models, I search for CVDI, what kind of model I could use. I decided to use this any map flick. Could use other models though. If you train a realistic LoRA, you should use realistic model. If you use anime, use the anime low checkpoint in this case. Anime Flix is 1.9 gigs, but you don't need to download this. Just click, right click here, just copy the link. And back to paste the link here, and then play. It's gonna take very fast. After that, you can download PAE if you have that. I don't use it. And then data acquisition. Data acquisition, this is one of the most important thing. LoRA is as good as the image that you trained. So for me, I use content 130, the 3.1 here. I play here. Colab's gonna create a new folder here called LoRA and has train data. You need to put a train data here. So how to train the data? To train data, you need to collect images. In this case, Ryuji Sakamoto. Just I couldn't find his models anywhere in CVTI. Maybe I just grab that searching. Here you have an image. Not, you know, the ideal is 100, I heard, but, you know, you could do less. And I suggest you put the same image, but cut through. Like here, I have two image here, it's the same image. You know, you just cut it off. Make sure you have only their face or their body and, you know, as much as possible, remove things that are unnecessary. I get this from the net, I get a few images here from the in-game scene. Okay, this is the same image. This is the same image, I just crop, you know, so training could recognize it better. After that, hold this, control all, and then drag this image to the train data here. So you have all the PNG or whatever file that you want here. After the upload is finished, you're gonna have all the image here. Now, you do data cleaning, just press this. If you have MP4, webcam, and GIF, it's gonna be removed. So make sure you don't have these things in your folder, especially if you think it's important. And then convert, if you want to convert the background, especially if you have like transparent background. This if you want to put random color. This is if you want recursive to check all the image inside the folder. Okay, next it's captioning. Okay, captioning, this thing suggests to use flip captioning for general emits and waifu diffusion for anime and manga styles, and that's why I do. I usually use flip captioning, you know, it's very simple. You just play and then it's gonna create a tag for every single image here. And the text is usually more like a sentence, so like a girl wearing a what, sitting in what. So it's depend on your mid and max length. So this is word for word. If it's 5 minimal, so if the image could be described in 5 words, it's gonna be finished. But if not, it's gonna use like 10 words or something you want. But the more word you use, and if the image is simple, it's gonna repeat the word. So read carefully, you know. This is verbal slow game, so you know what they do on the round. Okay, next is waifu diffusion. This is what I use for creating the Ryuji LoRA. We don't need to change this model if you have any other model that you want to use, but what the default is pretty good. The recursive verb was loading, you need to do this. And then these are tags if you want to remove certain tags that you don't want on the image. Then general threshold and character threshold. And here, after you click play, if you feel sure about that, and it's gonna generate this tag for every image here. Character tag is playing, I don't understand, but you know, it'll work. After that, you add caption tag. This is, I put Ryuji Sakamoto here. And then I play, after I check a pen, so hit 8, Ryuji Sakamoto tags on every image. After that, it's time to train, you know. You need to do this. If you use SD1.5, you just let it, it's unchecked, V2 and V-formatized. Project name is the project name you use. It's gonna be the name of the LoRA too, so make sure you name it right. Pre-trained model path. Okay, pre-trained model path is the model that you download. It's usually in this folder, okay? Just right-click and copy path here and put it here. It's the model you download in the step 2 here. So in model, and it's gonna create a folder here. If it not show up yet, you just click refresh. Hope it help. And to show this folder too, it's, yeah, okay. If you started, you might not see this. You could close it and you could show it pressing this button. Okay, that output there, make sure you output to drive so you could put the output to your Google Drive. Why? Because sometimes it takes a while to process this, and you could actually leave this thing, you know, when it's processing, doing something else. But since it's a free, if the progress or the runtime is stopped, you might lose the data if you not output it to the drive. The runtime already disconnect because, you know, there's no interaction again, and Google doesn't want that, you know. It's free. If you don't interact with it, better use it resource for someone else. So it's gonna cut your runtime and all your data gonna be gone. So make sure you put it on the drive. Display it, it's gonna create the setting, dataset repeats, it's gonna repeat how the data use an activation word, use Ryuji Sakamoto here, that it doesn't use if you use the tag, but you know, I usually do this. Just use 10, okay? Resolution, keep it this 512, you know? Don't increase it, cause if you use the free tier, just leave it at its. And as it repeat, you could increase it if you want the data to be repeat much more time. But it's not really important. And me, LoRA and optimizer setting, I don't really understand this. So I just usually just play here and it gotta create a setting. Branding config, use LoRA. It's usually more severe if I use this. It's not. And abruptly, sometimes and abruptly, if you have many images, I usually stick with more RAM. It's gonna take more process time, but I think it's more safe to do that. So, click play, save precision. I use float, usually FP16, but I have no sense. I use GTX 1660 Super. It's usually, it couldn't read half, so it's not half. I use float anyway. Cause that's not gonna use FP16. After that, you could just start creating right away. Okay, it's number of VFOG if you want. How many generation you want, you know, usually 10 is already great, but if you want like 20, 30 epochs, you could do it. The more epoch you use, the more the image gonna be very similar to the current models or the Switch image. So it might not be flexible about that. See what I said, it's this comic. But since we are here, I guess, you know, it realized, hey, there's still guy here doing this. So it's not the legal runtime. Okay, config, get the config, go to sample prompt. And here you could setting, you know, it has default setting, but you could choose this. This is the positive setting. What text that you will use for the sample, and then put the negative here after M here, and then, you know, save, like control S, play the models, start training. It's gonna take quite a time here. You could do something else, then generate, meet all the models, hold the training, Don't worry about the resolution. It's kind of unknown what resolution you use. It's gonna take quite some time. Surely it's 10 epochs, so it's gonna 10 time process. And every epoch, it's gonna generate the sample. The sample gonna be put on your Google Drive. Here, for example, is the sample that I have. It's gonna be located on the output. Yeah, so my drive, LoRA, output, and sample. We're gonna see the example here. This is the first epoch. It's really strange. Image. This is the second epoch. This is the third epoch. It's become really Ryuji. This is the fourth epoch. This is the five. This is the six. This is the seven. This is the eight. This is the 90 epoch. This is really, really Ryuji Sakamoto now. This is the 10. Sometimes it's not really great, but it depends on the seed too. So if you have doubt, here's all the epochs. Thus, it also generate all the models. This is the third epoch. If you go below, there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 9, and this is the last epoch. You could use all this as the models, so don't worry about that. It's gonna generate here too. After that, you download the model and you put it on the LoRA folder and then back to stable to function. This is the model we create, okay? So, depending on the models that you use, it gonna generate anime, but it could also generate realistic model if you use some realistic model. For example, let's change the model here from animation to realistic. I have this, you know, lot of model here. Let's try my fired model currently, Zoya for real. It's gonna take some time, so let's skip this. Okay, 54 seconds, not bad. Usually it needs to adjust the prompt, you know, especially the negative and positive word. Besides the LoRA stuff, you need to adjust it according to the model's rules, but you know, it's usually not very much. So we're trying to generate here using real models. We have the seed too, the same seed that generate these on the other models. Let's see what kind of things be the result of this. Okay, it's not, it still generate an anime model. I should add realistic. Okay, I tried to add this new prompt here, a new negative prompt. It might generate better realistic, and you know, like usual, this is the original models. We still use the same seed, but a better word. Before realistic, it should generate a real person, right? This is the Ryuji in realistic version. Sometimes it's error, so yeah. It's using a Zoya realistic version. It generated a new Ryuji, that is. Hey, we could decrease the size here, so it's not really that bad. Maybe we could add full body here. Let's just skip. Okay. This is also Ryuji, but I think to make sure you are sure about this. Okay, this is the result. Okay, I tried to, you know, back to anime because, you know, it's not gonna convince you that people won't work with this, but you know, we have trouble with the eyebrow. So make sure you handle that color eyebrow here. Okay, this is the result. Okay, this is also generate, you know. Okay, this is the last slot of the image generation. There's a problem with the lag of his kind of strange, but you know, it's the right pants, right jackets, the right cleavage and stuff. So make sure you do edit this. So it able to generate what you want. Anyway guys, I hope that helped. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like, share, and comment. And see you again on the next episode. Have a nice day.